Hi guys, and welcome to a Brown Car Guy Bulletin. In this one, I will be answering the question, should you buy a car in lockdown 2? As some of you will know here, particularly in England, we have a lockdown until December the 2nd. So we're going to get into whether or not this is a good time to buy a car. Before we do that, make sure that you're subscribing to this channel, which is youtube.com/browncarguy. Make sure you're subscribing to all of my social media channels. You can find them easily by just searching the hashtag. It's on my hat right there. #browncarguy. And of course, subscribe to browncarguy.com. Of course, if you like my content, you can also sponsor it on patreon.com/ShazadSheikh. I'll tell you more about that at the end of the video. Cool, let's get into this. In the first lockdown, I correctly predicted there would be a car sales boom, particularly for used cars post-lockdown due to pent-up demand, but more crucially, in light of research and data that indicated that more people wanted to have their own cars and avoid using public transport due to fears over COVID-19. So, for example, there were X million people who had driving licenses but didn't actually own cars. That was a huge ready potential market straight away. And sure enough, this is exactly what came to pass. Of course, just as you might expect, after the initial surge in the summer post first lockdown, the clamor for cars started to slow a little, and that was for several reasons. Those that had been wanting to buy a car from before had bought them, and those that had decided to buy a car during lockdown had also bought them. But then there was the whole will it end or not over the furlough scheme, i.e. people started to worry if they would still have money coming in. And compound this with the airports and airlines and mothballs and the leisure and hospitality industries collapsing, job losses and unemployment had subsequently soared. There were other factors too due to the pandemic. Many more of us were and are continuing to work from home, which means that some people don't need that commuting car anymore, or maybe they decided to downgrade since the leasing deal might be proving a bit costly, and in light of economic uncertainty, maybe it's just unnecessary. Plus, you know, for some people, a car is about image and presentation, and if you're not taking it to the office or to meetings, then perhaps you no longer need a flash motor. So, you know, you chop it in for something a little more affordable and probably more practical. And of course, people get lazy. If you've put off buying a car for a bit, time drags on, and that urgency that you might have felt during the first lockdown when you were thinking, I really want to have a car, that might have waned. Or with the surge of prices, you might have thought, let's just wait and see. The good news is you haven't waited too long. Not yet, anyway. In fact, prices did start to ease. The market did calm down. Some additional new car sales during the September plate change did replenish used stock, although at the same time we all became aware of the notorious not so secret stockpiles of cars waiting to be sold in various airfields around the country and defunct racetracks like Rockingham, which is kind of sad. It turns out there are still plenty of cars out there and there's no longer a mad rush to buy them. So if there's enough stock and prices are sensible again, then it becomes all about what sort of cars do people actually want or need? As I've said, some car owners would have downgraded, wanting to save money and not needing something so ostentatious and status conscious to impress their peers, perhaps. While on the other hand, some people found themselves in the fortunate position of saving money during the first lockdown, you know, from not going out, not going on holiday, not commuting, and just not spending as much money as they normally would, apart from on toilet rolls and pasta. Many of these people probably figured that they might as well treat themselves to a nicer car than they would have otherwise bought, or even upgrade their existing car. You can't blame them, especially if you've been tragically and sadly spooked by the loss of life amongst friends and loved ones and uncertainty about the future caused by COVID. You know, at some point you can't help think, yeah, I don't know how long we're all going to live. You only live once. Sod it. Let's just get the Porsche Beamer or whatever cool car that you've always dreamt of. And you know what? Why the heck not? It remains been kind of hard to predict what cars will sell most. I do think used cars are still leading the way, and there's probably a divide of popular metal between the sub 15 grand cars that are sensible, affordable, practical, and the higher, more desirable metal. Newer cars are still struggling a little, as indicated by production rates that are falling, and despite everyone talking about electric cars, it's the good old school internal combustion engine that people are naturally migrating towards, and that too the petrol variant, not so much diesel, which has been demonized of late. So what about right now in lockdown 2.0? Well, as I said, prices appear to have stabilized a little and car buying momentum dropped to a reasonably healthy tick over. I say healthy, that's a relative term considering the economy at large at the moment. However, car sales tend to normally slow in the winter. People don't want to be trudging around in the cold, wet weather and early nights inspecting and checking out cars, right? Plus, usually they are saving up for Christmas. Typically, car sales then pick up again in January. Now this year people aren't likely to be traveling that much for Christmas, and with only 3 weeks left until Santa drops by after the lockdown ends in England, if it ends on schedule, which is December the 2nd, they may find that they end up saving more money than they were expecting. I must say it's all a bit uncertain though, because regional or nationwide lockdowns might continue as the virus is still very much on the rampage. I mean, yesterday we had the highest deaths since the first peak, sadly. May they all rest in peace, and may those that they have left behind find the strength to cope with the loss. So the whole question of lockdown being extended is still possible, especially if the current lockdown isn't effective enough. Or maybe it will, and of course there's some good news now about the vaccine and the suggestion that there's even a small chance it might start to get deployed by the first week of December. You know, just as the international money markets have shot up, so consumer confidence might surge and spending may happen big time. Of course, it all makes the car market a little volatile to predict, even more so than the last lockdown, I reckon. But people like used car experts Cap aren't expecting values to fall off a cliff, but do expect them to be suppressed. On the other hand, Auto Trader had a survey which revealed that 58% of people that had been thinking about buying a car before the lockdown were undeterred and planned to go ahead and buy a new motor vehicle within 2 weeks of lockdown. 7% even said, as already discussed, that it made them want to purchase the car even quicker. Only 14% that said that it had actually put them off. There are no figures or data, of course, since the revelation of the vaccine, but considering that the reality is that it will take time for the vaccine to be administered and take hold throughout society, you know, we're probably looking at the continued presence of coronavirus at least until April next year. The other big difference with lockdown 2.0, of course, is that you can still buy cars. Okay, so dealers technically have had to close their forecourts, being non-essential retailers, but online sales, home deliveries, and click and collect services are allowed and in operation, which of course is a big change in consumer behavior as well, because most people previously prefer to buy a car in person rather than online. And again, going back to the Christmas thing, if there's a chance that people will get to visit families and spend time with them over the festive period and don't want to use public transport, that also provides an added impetus to buy a car sooner rather than later. To the question then, should you buy a car in lockdown 2.0? Yes and no. No, because as I always tell people, they need to check out a car for themselves, they need to take it for a drive, both to see if it all works as it should, but also to make sure that it's right for them and their family's needs. Having said that, I've several times bought cars off eBay sight unseen in the past myself, but then I'm in the fortunate position to have experienced many cars due to what I do. So that's the no part. The yes part is because prices have settled down, dealers are desperate, and it is still possible to buy a car. Perhaps not everyone is aware that they can buy cars during the lockdown. Perhaps not everyone is willing because of a lack of financial security, which put those that can and are able to buy a car in a better bargaining position. However, post-lockdown and post-vaccine announcement, things might change radically again, in that, as I've said, consumer confidence might grow, people might go out and about and hunt for cars just in time for Christmas, and those with funds left over, or those feeling that are more optimistic about 2021, which, let's face it, we all desperately need, to be honest, it may result in a traditional uplift as we see in January. All of that, of course, means the prices could rise. So yeah, if you're comfortable buying a car online, if you're already familiar with what you want and which car will be suitable for you, and if you are not, you can always seek out the opinion of experts like myself, then you know what? Go ahead and buy that motor. So there you go. There is what I think about whether or not you should buy a car in lockdown 2.0. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you are buying a car, or let me know if you are putting off buying a car. Mention why and all the details involved in the comments above below elsewhere. Let me know what you thought of this video and the comments above below elsewhere. Make sure that you're subscribing to youtube.com/browncarguy. Make sure you follow me on all the social media channels. Just search for my hashtag. It's on my hat, hashtag browncarguy. And of course, subscribe to browncarguy.com. If you enjoy my content, then you can sponsor me on patreon.com/ShazadShake and join such awesome people as Muhammad Ali Humaid in the UAE, Partha over in India, find him on parthans.com, Tom Conway Gordon here in the UK, Isaac Beauchard over in America, find him on bespokeautos.com, Reza Adil here, find him on Instagram, Ali Lizarde.cigars, and Muhammad Qasim, find him on WEMS.com. Anyway, it's all coming up below, so you'll see it all there, and also it'll be in the description below in this video, so you guys can join them, and that would be fantastic, because all of your support really, really helps. But if not, it also helps for you to keep pressing the like button, comment, sharing, subscribing, and telling all your friends to go and follow the Brown Car Guy. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you all again soon in the next one.